Hey guys, this is Kirob speaking, and we are back in Pro Cycling Manager 2016 with Dicky Mc Speck now on his last race on the Arabian Peninsula, the route of Oman it is. And as you can see from the little preview down there, there is a little bit of more challenging terrain featured in this tour. And we are going to go right into it. Our fitness levels are very decent, and we have set up the coming training already, and we try to keep a reasonably high fitness level throughout the next month or three. So we hope the red line isn't rising all too fast. Anyway, so let's get into the route of Oman. All right, here we are, zero race day condition, and we are once again kind of taking on the big guns here. It's the usual suspects. No, and that is not Mr. Cockburn, but rather Marcel Kittel and Greipel and so on. So lots of big guns down here, and they all seem to like Arabia. Well, they are kind of flat stages down here. But this tour will be a bit different. And not attack. Only will it be it's different because, yeah, those guys are attacking. But, focus on Mc Speck. There we go. Not only is it different because it will be hilly, but also patch 1.4 just came out, and they addressed the problem of the peloton not riding properly in the closing stages of the race. So that means that it's much harder to get an attack succeeding at the in the final stages of a race. So we basically they basically fixed the issue we pointed out so many times, which allowed Mc Speck to win so many races in his first season. That should not have happened, really. And now it's fixed, and it makes perfect sense to. Oh my God! What's going on here? They are really going at it. But it's all good and good and well, because now we are in a more professional setting after all. So it should get harder now, and it's not only getting harder because the races are getting harder, but also because they patched the stupid AI. So yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing how that goes. There is a lot of wind in this stage, and that is why I want to really stick to the front, so no crosswinds cutting me off or something. That would be terrible. But the second half of the stage will be mostly downhill. I'm not too afraid of that. On the other hand, the speed probably will be reasonably quick, as the escapees are also benefiting or from the downhill in general. And this is a little bit of undulated terrain here, but we are heading down. Ah, that must be a pleasure to drive, to ride. Let's check the wind though. If it's downwind downhill for that amount of distance, I think I would be, well, not able to ride 60 there all the time, but I would definitely enjoy the small ride. And just look at how they are going. My God. That's really quick. And it's still 3 minutes on the clock. Don't have anybody in the breakaway group. Also, with the patch, the game seems to have reset my graphics settings, so I will have to switch off this terrible motion blur in a bit after this stage. What is going on here? Anton seems to accelerate. No. No, okay. They're not quite, they don't know what they're doing again, once again. 14 kilometers left, no, 17 kilometers left, and wow, okay, that means they are very far ahead still, so maybe they even get through with the breakaway. They were riding really hard, and, well, if you are riding downhill, oh, comment on, Mc Speck, if you're riding downhill, downwind, the peloton can't make that big of a difference. It is more in headwind situations where the peloton really can rail in the escapees easily. And then you wonder, well, Kirob, Tell me, as a physicist, you should know why that is. Well, that is because you are on average riding faster with the wind in your back and rolling downhill, but with lower wind resistance, the... Oh, now I have to watch out here. Is there a good wheel? Greipel. So we should try to catch this wheel. There is more rolling resistance at higher speeds, of course. And that means that even if you hide in someone's back, in the shade, slipstream, it's called, in the slipstream of someone, you will... Is this a sprinter? Yes, it is. But he's going slow. This is all not that good. Okay. So even if you're then going, you would be going fast, but if you're hiding, you still need to invest more energy. So overall, the peloton has less of an advantage because there are so many riders hiding there who then have to invest more energy than they usually would. So it's tiring them out. And 5 kilometers left to go. Our resistance bar is completely empty almost. It's just so fast riding. So the field would be tired out harder than they usually would, and that means that the escapees are not at a disadvantage as big as you would expect. 2.9 kilometers to go. I don't know if I can... No, he disconnected. Let's see if... No, it's this shit again.
And the final sprint is off. Who's going to be the first to the line today?
Well, okay. We just sprint and see what comes out of it. 1 kilometer left to go. The escapees did get through, it seems. It was pretty nicely done by them. Oh, no, they didn't. Oh, Lasse Hansen is the only one who made it through. Pretty impressive. Are we even on the list? No, we are not. Okay, there are too many people in front. Oh no, there we are. 6th position. That wasn't too bad, even though we didn't get a rear wheel. Or the game didn't let us get a rear wheel. Wow, these stats are pretty impressive. Let me turn off this horrible motion blur once again, because that is not okay. If you look at this, so the favorites supposedly are Kittel and Evan and Greipel and Matthews, and well, he definitely has a big chance because look at him, he's basically a puncher sprinter. But Greipel, Evan and Kittel are not good in the hills, so we might have a little... What? Zoom on Dicky Mc Speck. Well, what I can tell you is that you don't have to zoom that much because you more need a wide angle lens to picture him. But yes, this is a good opportunity for Mc Speck to pull off a major coup. Wow, how did they know that? He can move up the point standings and why not go for the stage? Fucking hell, they see my evil plan. Yeah. I can certainly do that. And are we on the list? No, we aren't. So I'm looking forward to trying this out. Oh, maybe we could pull something off for the sub 25 as well. But yeah, this final hill, if we can get there and pull out our spec bar and just get across it. We are really good at downhill, don't forget that. So if we can be in the front group on the top here, which will be tough because they're really, really good mountain, hill guys in here. But yeah, you never know. Let's see how it goes. Oh no, we have a -4 race day condition. That is terrible. So today won't be a day we can do anything, basically. So let's just get through it. Damn it. All right. Yeah, we are not doing well today at all. Like, usually that would have not been an issue with the... even losing any stamina or resistance there, it seems. But today, it's really bad. Let's try to stay with this group over the coming hill. 200 height meters and 3.3 kilometers long, so it's pretty short. But and it's getting flat on top. But we definitely do want to have a position up front. I think today we will have the problem that usually our teammates have, just running out of resistance bar before the action really kicks in. 11 kilometers to go, and because of our shit resistance, we have 58! 58, that is terrible, and 59 stamina. We won't make it even into the hill, it seems. Or, well, maybe into half of the hill, and then we die. Not a very successful day, even though the profile would have been perfect for us.
Yes.
So there we are. Not a chance in hell. I mean, we had nothing left at the end. And it looks like an escapee or two escapees have won once again. That's impressive. So maybe they've changed the AI a little bit for the escape groups as well. I would have to check that. Potentially they have.
The profile of this race is quite flat. Expect a fast pace from the peloton.
Ah, much better. A zero race day condition today, and a very interesting route. Just look at this hill. Oh my god. This looks terrible. I hope we survive that, but the finishing stages of this race are really interesting too. Look at this this terrain. This little ramp there, it's like 7% steepness at the end. Very interesting. That should be pretty cool. Let's see, we have actually perfectly zero down here, so what's going on? Ah, those attackers once again. And today there is a massive amount of wind, so we have to stay at the front or near the front at all times. Let's stay there. And if we, yeah, we expect quite a few... let's say packs to form after a while if there are crosswinds, and those will probably not get back until, well, ever. That, by the way, is what is going on? They're all bunching up and not riding at all. What are they just giving up? No, they're going. Alright, they just wanted to give the escape group a significant advantage such that they can win today's stage. I mean, what the fuck? The AI is a little bit messy in this game, it's at times, it seems. And now they're riding super hard. Just because, oh shit, they have 8 minutes on the clock! That's not how it's supposed to be. Well, yeah, you just let them ride away for like half an hour without even pedaling. Oh yeah, now I remember what I was getting at. Like in the team aspect of this game, like where you manage a whole team, I like to have, when I had a stronger team, I like to create the situation where my whole team rides hard at the front in like little boosts, and that would end up like splitting off quite a few groups at the back of the peloton in the crosswinds. So it was kind of funny to see. Usually worked really well if you then caught a favorite to win in that. That would be perfect. So now we are riding hard into this hill because it's super steep. And they are not really reacting. Okay, that's good. So now maybe at this pace we can even tire out one of the sprinters or so, because we're not doing too terrible. And now it's super steep. 9, 12, 14, 16%, 17% steepness. Yeah, that is quite a steep climb. It's almost like the Odenwald. A little bit more dusty though. And now they are riding. Wow, look at that. So we did do a good job at rubber banding properly. Let's hope it doesn't completely drop off. Oh, we want to be up front. Hello. We want to be there. So accelerate, Mc Speck. Downhill is something you know how to do. Oh, they are really drawn out now, trying to get back to the front. Whoa, do you see that? The leader's jersey is in a back group. So let's just go with 80 here. We definitely don't want to lose contact to those guys up front here, because we might climb in the general classification a little bit. Well, yeah, look at that. The red jersey, the leader's jersey, is far, far behind. But now they're coming back. They are indeed coming back. Now they are back. Okay, it wasn't too bad. But yeah, that's what hills and crosswinds can do to you. And now they are riding super hard once again. What the hell is going on? This is not normal riding. But just 4 minutes on the clock. And I've almost lost all the resistance again. This is crazy. So it seems like I actually have to fetch water bottles now, because no one else is doing that and no one else is left in the peloton. They're all dead. And we have basically no stamina left either. The green bar is almost empty. So no chance in the final stages of this stage either. It was really tough riding. I don't really know what's going on with this new AI. It's very strange. Oh shit. Yeah, you can see what's happening here. Those guys are going up front. We have no resistance bar left. And now comes a final little incline. 6-7%. Let's see how steep this is. Yeah. Around 6%. And we have no chance to get anywhere in the finish, as we are already losing our sprint bar. We just don't have enough stamina for this. This is mainly because our green bar is almost empty, so our general level of speed is very low. So we have to invest quite a bit of power to even keep pace with this. And the escapees are getting through once again. Look at that. Well, that is the 2 or 3 minutes they just got for free at the start of the race, which was completely ridiculous. And now we are kind of not doing anything. They are not sprinting, doing nothing, just recuperating. So that, yeah, I don't know why. No more hard riding. Maybe they are all tired, just as me. There's someone attacking. Let's follow him. No, everyone is following. And we can't really follow. Is that what you call sprinting, Mc Speck? Yes, okay. A short burst of nothing. And here we go. Through the line. Across the line. And what a stage. What chaos. Yeah, today is looking rather fine for a day that is this. Huh. Canola? Is he a climber guy? I would have to check that. Where is Canola? It's difficult to see here. Hello? Who are you? There we go. Alright, he has a pretty shit race day condition and just mountains 62. He won't do very well today. And we just follow his order, stay in the peloton for the rest of the day, I guess. But the peloton will be dying up this slope, so I don't know what I'm going to do here. I think I will try to have as much of a rest day as possible, because longer tours aren't Mc Speck's thing, like this one. 6 days, that's too much. And we only have a recovery of 64. We don't want to sacrifice anything for the final days. And the recovery, how much you lose for your fitness for the or freshness for the following day, depends on how much you have left of your green bar. So if we can get through this and lose lots of time on the final climb by just going up the climb with like 55 or something, we lose lots of time, but we will be more fresh for the coming days. And that is more important than not losing 20 minutes on this stage. So we are going with that. Alright, we are closing in on the final climb. Today was a much, much more standard day. We had a headwind that certainly helped us, especially those guys in the peloton. So it's just 2 minutes left to the escape group of 9 people, and the favorite certainly will crush that advantage on the final climb. We are not so concerned about that. So we want to get in as some of the first people into the climb, not losing too much of our resistance, and then just going easy up the incline. All right, so I think they start moving up right now, and they're already attacking, or is this in the group up there? Wow, that is super steep. That is a massive climb. Wow. Okay. Great mountain. Yes, it's a great mountain. It is brutal. 9.9% average over the course of 7.1 kilometers. You climb 1,000... What? No, that's the final altitude, because 10%, 7.1 kilometers is 700... meters height difference, so that's not correct, but the final height will be 1,303 meters. So yes, what we wanted to do is just chill. So now we put it on 60 and just take it easy. Look how everyone is dying and we're just chilling. You Cheetos and some crisps, and don't forget about the currywurst. No, currywurst is haram, so we are not allowed to eat that here. 5 kilometers to the finish, and we have plenty of green bar left. Look, we are with Mr. Cockburn. We are in the autobus. That's the where the, all the sprinters basically go. And wow, yeah, he's really bad. Oh, he could ride faster, but yeah, this is the in general the place where all the slow people are who don't really care. And they're already done. Wow, that was quick. We're just like halfway through it. Yeah. And there we go. That was easy. And here are the key moments of the race. Oh, that was a close finish between those three. All right, let's see how much time we lost on this stage. Up there we are. 14 minutes on that climb. Well, it's all good. Mc Speck, you're my hero. I know you're faster going downwards. So this should give us a very decent recovery if they are actually calculating that correctly. Yes, it looks like it. So perfect freshness there. No worries whatsoever. We are fresh for the next sprinting and hilly stages. Hopefully we don't get food poisoning once again. Oh, okay. A zero. A very hot day, and look at these climbs. That is more like a mountain stage, or it's some in between, I would say, because those are not really hills. Today should be a reasonably easy day, because there's just one rider in the escape group, and there are these little hills here along the way, which we... or this little hill here, especially, and the one which we are getting into right now. We don't want to have anything bad happen to us there, and there's a lot of wind today too. Do we have headwind? No, side crosswinds. Wow. So what we want to do is rubber band across these as well as we can. All right, so here comes the little super steep hill, and that is what I would call a hill, not something like the middle one here. This is just crazy. That's a mini mountain, and quite long for being called a hill, but let's see how this little one goes first. So we are entering it now. It should be super steep, and Mc Speck is... it's 11%, 12% steepness, and Mc Speck is riding at 150 heart rate, even though he's limited to 60. I still don't get why that is. Maybe he's being pushed from behind by riders who want to get to the front, because he should be limited to a heart rate of 140 by this. But nope, he isn't. Maybe just because it's so steep that he can't escape. But he has a hill rating of 68, so it shouldn't be too bad. He got across among the first, and now hopefully in the little downhill that was can recuperate a little. And let's see how badly they are dying in the rear. So overall, this day suits me really well with this single guy in the escape group, because that means the peloton will be riding super slow overall. and that means that I have my full resistance bar left for the hills, and I think that will kind of blow up after the first one. And now, whoop, now they start moving really hard, and we cannot allow ourselves to get away here because, oh, okay, it's, wind from behind. Tailwind, that makes it harder to ride in a fast in a peloton, like I said in the, one of the last stages. Now they're moving in at full speed into this killer climb. Wow, this is tough.
Attack by Breschel.
Are they already attacking here? Well, I guess you, if you are a puncher and really like this terrain, then you could make a go for it and just take the stage from here. But that's a long way to ride, 40 kilometers left within that terrain, that's brutal. And the next climb here is not much easier. Just look at that profile on the top there. It's cruel. 3.5 kilometers long only, but you're climbing quite a bit. And we have no chance to even stay with those guys at any reasonable pace. Just 10 kilometers left, and let's see if we can just ride a little bit among those left behind. A16! How bad is that? It's amazing. Yes, and that is basically what I was saying about this being more like a mountain stage. Alberto Contador took it, and he is a climber, not a a puncher. This was just a bit too hard to be a hilly stage. And let's see if Mc Speck can sprint a little. There is someone who tries to do the same. What? Mc Speck isn't even reacting. He's tucked in there. Oh, what a fail. Well, that was just far too difficult on this stage. It's no chance. You need to be a climber here to... Yeah, and we are really not. 58 isn't enough, and 68 hill definitely isn't enough either. And again, a zero race day condition. I think that should be pretty good. We just hope for an escape group not to be too large. We don't have much wind today either, so it's pretty easy riding overall, I hope at least. And what we are taking a look at is these actual little hills, not mountains, right before the end. So that makes positioning really important, and not so much how much hill you have, although that certainly would help if we had a little bit more. But Mc Speck is still training towards a puncher, so that will happen eventually. Today I will allow Mc Speck to rubber band here, and I hope that will give us a little bit of an advantage in the final stages of this race. Because, as you can see, they are riding pretty hard. They will lose more of their green bar as well as quite a bit of their resistance bar potentially. So if we have both of these still filled up at the end, that would be nice. And for these little hills, it is vital for us to have the maximum amount of resistance bar left at the end of the day, as well as the green bar, that is even more important. We only have 67 stamina for this day. So the first mountain here is done. We rubber banded across it like a pro, like in the old days of Mc Speck clubbing seals. And now the downhill should help us get back into position at the front. Alright, we're getting into the final stages, and this is a nice little downhill leading, just a very subtle downhill leading down to the first incline. And positioning is king here because it's so short, probably just a kilometer. The breakaway could make it right to the finish. No, I doubt they can make it right to the finish. That potentially doesn't happen. So, now, someone is just stopping here. Why is that? You just want to let them go or something? Let's hold up right at the front. We take position here. And, once again, I have a little bug, which is rather nasty, that my pause key is no longer working. That sometimes happens. And now I have to just adjust it via this one. So, yes. Let my mouse help you out here. Provisional standings, please go away, because I want to see the... No, I want to see the mountain. And my... Fuck. My button doesn't work. So what is the mountain? It's very short, as you can see here. Slightly more than a kilometer in length. And we are riding really, really slow. Now pause. 5 kilometers to go. Yes, we are getting close to here. That's the problem. I can't view this map and click up there at the same time. I need my fucking pause button. So, yes, let's get to the foot of the hill.
15 kilometers remaining.
And why did Mc Speck accelerate here? I don't know. Also, I don't quite know why they are not riding. So let me try to just place a little attack and see what happens.
Look, the pack has taken its foot off the gas. The team leaders can't be.
Yeah, we are getting away.
The riders are going
we are actually getting away. It's
10%.
Really steep here, and Mc Speck is just handling it like a pro. Very nice. All right. So this is 16 kilometers from the finish line. So we probably don't want to ride faster than like 75 from here on. So let's continue with that. We got 1 minute and 20 from this action. And Mc Speck, because he lost so much time in the mountain stage, they just let him drive. It's like, yeah, whatever, Mc Speck. You do what you do. So we can potentially get some time back on some of the other riders who are in the young riders jersey. And we even took two of the escapees back. We don't have any bar left, but 37 seconds on them. So we are 7th overall in this stage. That was a nicely placed attack. Cost us, well, it doesn't matter what it costs us in the stamina bar, because, well, this is the last stage, right? So, yeah, why not? That was a pretty good maneuver. I should have reacted a little bit earlier, seeing that they were slowing down, but I think I caught it within a few seconds. So, anyway, that was very successful, even though we didn't have a pause button or keys to modify the game speed. And there we go. So let's take a look at the general classification and the standings, young rider standings. Yes, we did take, I think, a place or two or something like that. Yeah, okay, so that was rather decent overall. Anyway, so this was in general much too hard, too far. So what we are going to look at is what is coming up next before we wrap up this episode. We have a few little classics in between here. That will be interesting, especially now that they fixed the last kilometer escape AI, that it's not as easy anymore. And this one didn't work for us now, right. So yeah, I think that is coming up next here. And here we see the profile. So a little bit of a hilly, wavy thing, reasonably short. Then perfectly flat, and one which is a little bit hilly. And I think this one we have the most chances in, because it sorts out the sprinters which don't really like hills at all, and is still a sprint finish which we can place well in. And then we are getting back to a seal clubbing tour. That will be fun. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed, and see you next time.